suppose, you know, preparations, this has been a long season. We'll be together almost 130 times Sunday. It's game number 39. We have the County Junior League final to follow the following week, so it's 40 games in one season. It's a long season, but we have a big squad of players, a very focused group, and I suppose we've been conscious for a while now that we're not alone representing our club and our division, but we're representing our county, and Cork have an appalling record in both the junior and intermediate championships in modern times. And it's well known now that Cork have lost the Kerry the last 20 contests between the counties. And in fact, Cork have never, ever won a Munster junior final against Kerry. So the stats are stacked against us, no doubt about it. But we're expecting to make a good account of ourselves. We will play a positive game. We're very much up for it and we're ready to go.
Well, I was going to say, you've come through Tipperary and Waterford opposition in Munster alone, but it's always a different story against Kerry side.
It is, but I think with respect now, I think the difference here this time is that the geography of our club is important here. We're in the parish of Ratmore, which is on the border with Kerry, and Ratmore and Ginevgwilla, the two Kerry clubs and ourselves, are sister clubs really, divided by the river, Blackwater. We have no fear of playing in Kerry and playing Kerry teams, and indeed at the start of the season, we had a great boost at the start of the season. We won the Paddy O'Shea tournament and we beat teams from Kerry for that. So it's not an issue for us. We're not afraid of that by no means. And, you know, we've played well in the county championship. We've won it deservingly, and I think on merit. And in Munster, we certainly haven't pulled back on our performances. We've gone all out for it. But we've managed to rotate our squad as well and keep them fresh.
As you mentioned the geography, how is it out there this week coming up against Drummond Pearse's, you know, because of the geography?
It's great because historically, Ratmore, Ginevgwilla would support us and we would support them. So the fact that we are playing a team from Kerry, they'll still be supporting us, I can tell you that. But it isn't just that. Listen, we have massive support from all over Duhallow. There's a lot of things at stake here because no Duhallow club. Duhallow is supposed to be originally a football division. We have won two club titles in Duhallow now in hurling. Meelin won in Ireland 6-7 years ago. Kentuck recently won a great intermediate championship final. But no Duhallow club has ever won a Munster junior or intermediate or any club football championship or the Duhallow division. So we are trailblazers. We're aware of it. We're not afraid of it. And we're certainly up for it, you know. So we have lots of support all over. And I think most neutrals would like to see the Kerry dominance changed. The other fact would be that Nemo having won last Sunday, for the first time, I think, in history ever, there's a chance that Cork could win two of the three available club titles in Munster by the end of this year. So it would be a great boost to Cork football.
Absolutely. I was just reading some comments from Declan O'Sullivan in the Examiner today, I think originally in the Kerryman, about Mallow being a home game for Knocknagree. Not too happy that you get what he perceives as home advantage this Sunday.
Yeah, well, I can tell you now, I'm not one bit impressed by that sort of a comment. Because I'll tell you, Declan, all with respect to him and his club, and they're down in South Kerry, it's a great football area. They have no problem taking clubs down there to play many of their games. And I'm sure my friends in Kentuck will remember this well. I actually am a self-employed in Kentuck for many years, and I'm a great supporter of Kentuck also. But in 2011, Kentuck won the Cork County Junior Football Final, I can tell you. A great win on a Friday night against Mitchelstown. And they had to go down to play Drummond Pearse that Sunday, and they were forced by the Munster Council to go to Drummond Pearse to play the game. They didn't even know where they were going, and really, they went down there to get into extra time. It left a lot of bad feeling at the time. And I didn't hear anyone from Kentuck complaining about that. You know, so what goes round comes round. It is a neutral venue, as far as the Munster Council are concerned. It's a marvellous venue. And, you know, that's a thing that would have been predestined a long time ago. The junior finals are always played in Kentuck. You have teams from Waterford and Tipperary playing the hurling final, and you know I don't hear them complaining. So you know, with respect, that's a little bit off the wall. You know, it is where it is. We're playing in Mallow. It's a fine pitch. Let the better team win.
Absolutely. And housekeeping wise, how's the squad looking for Sunday, John Finchan? Are you all right? You don't have a full complement for this game, of course.
No. I mean, that's well known for a long time. In the county final, I suppose one of our leading players, Anthony O'Connor, played in a game that the medic said he shouldn't play, and he sacrificed himself for the team. And he actually played in that game. We won the county championship, which was the major thing for us. But, you know, he's been out of football since. I don't think he'll play again until January. But we're not worried about that. Look, you get your injuries. That's what happens. But we believe in the players we have. We have an average age of 22 and a half. We've got a very focused group. If we lose on Sunday, I'm certainly not getting any excuses in here now in advance of the game. And I'm making any excuses. And I don't believe in it. I think you play the game where it's fixed. You'll be quite happy to play it where it's fixed. You'll get a big crowd. It's a wonderful thing that we have these club championships. I've mentioned it many times about Sean Kelly when he was president of the GAA and what he did in bringing those championships in. But from that point of view, you know, I'm really looking forward to it. There'll be a big crowd at the game. And Kerry have dominated this thing. They're looking for 10 in a row. We're trying to change it. If Drummond beat us, fair play to them if they do. They'll be better than us if they do. But we're certainly not afraid of playing this game and we're going all out for it.
Well, John Finton, the very best of luck to you, and we'll hopefully speak to you after a good result on Sunday. Thank you.
OK, thank you very much.